House passes Equality Act in a severe blow to religious liberty, women's rights. A landmark bill that would place sexual orientation and gender identity along rest in the nation's anti-discrimination laws passed the U.S. House of Representatives on Thursday and advanced to the Senate, where its prospects are far less certain. H.R. 5, also known as the Equality Act, passed the House 224-206 along a mostly party-line vote, with three Republicans joining 2-1 Democrats in support.
On this vote, the yeas are 224 and the nays are 206. The bill is passed.
All 206 no votes came from Republicans. Opponents say it would have a devastating impact on women's rights and religious freedom.
Life.
I rise in opposition to H.R. 5, yet another harmful bill that has been rushed to the House floor without thorough bipartisan consideration. It claims to strive for equality, but in practice, this bill undermines the constitutional religious freedoms guaranteed to all Americans. Once again, abandoning long-established House procedures, Democrats are pushing a conveniently titled bill without convening one hearing or markup during the 117th Congress to consider its vast implications for educational institutions and employers.
Although the House previously passed the bill in 2019, on Thursday, passage marked the first time it had passed with Democrats in control of the House. The Senate and the White House, a trifecta that gives it a legitimate chance of becoming a law. The Senate has never passed the Equality Act. Politico reported it is unlikely to pass that body in its current form. President Biden applauded the bill's passage, saying, "Transgender rights are human rights, and the House made that clear today by passing the Equality Act," he tweeted. "Now it's time for the Senate to do the same." The bill would amend the Civil Rights Act of 1964, a law that was passed to confront racial discrimination by adding sexual orientation and gender identity to the list of protected classes of public places, education, and employment. It guarantees that individuals cannot be denied access to a shared facility, including a restroom, a locker room, and a dressing room that is in accordance with the individual's gender identity. It would force schools to allow biological boys who identify as girls to play on girls' teams. Controversially, the bill explicitly forbids individuals from using the Religious Freedom Restoration Act of 1993 to sue based on claims within the Equality Act. The 1993 law signed by President Clinton prevents the government from substantially burdening a person's exercise of religion. The Equality Act offers no protection for religious freedom, Alliance Defending Freedom said in an analysis. Representative Mike Johnson, during floor debate, argued his colleagues to oppose the bill. "Everybody in this chamber believes that all people are entitled to dignity and respect. We believe that every single person is made in the image of God. And because of that, every single person has inestimable dignity and value," Johnson said. "But this bill is a severe blow to women's rights, to people of faith, to every parent, every student, every medical professional, and so many more. Because we believe in the dignity and value of every person, we have to oppose this dangerous un-American legislation." House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy also highlighted the bill's impact on religious liberty and women's rights. "If you look at Biden's appointments of cabinet members, suing nuns and others, this really seems like an onslaught against freedom of religion, for girls' sports as well," McCarthy said in a press conference. "Now the Democrats have even taken it further. The pro-life Susan B. Anthony List warned that the bill would protect abortion rights. That's because the bill adds pregnancy, childbirth, or a related medical condition to the definition of sex, which courts have interpreted broadly to include abortion," Susan B. Anthony List said in a news release. Tennis legend Martina Navratilova co-wrote a Washington Post editorial in 2019 warning that the Equality Act would do significant damage to women's sports by making it unlawful to differentiate among girls and women in sports on the basis of sex for any purpose. Alliance Defending Freedom this month warned that the Equality Act should be concerned to anyone who values religious freedom and true equality. Alliance Defending Freedom says the Equality Act would, number one, forbid churches and religious nonprofits from requiring their employees to live out their religious beliefs about marriage, sexual morality, and the distinction between the sexes. Churches and religious nonprofits could be required to open their sex-specific facilities to members of the opposite sex. Number two, threaten religious foster care and adoption agencies with closure if they operate according to their deeply held belief that the best place for a child is a home with a married mother and father. And number three, threaten creative professionals and other business owners who simply want to live and work according to their beliefs. As an example, ADF mentioned a Christian printer in Kentucky who refused to print an LGBT pride shirt and was ordered by the local Human Rights Commission to undergo diversity training. Number three, force individuals to speak messages that violate their beliefs under the threat of punishment. ADF referenced a Christian man who is a university professor who was disciplined for not referring to a biological male student as a woman. The student identifies as female. Alliance Defending Freedom General Counsel Christine Wagner on Thursday argued the Senate to defeat the bill. Our nation's law should respect the most fundamental freedoms of every American citizen. But the deceptively titled Equality Act hides behind promises of toleration and empowerment, while its policies threaten real harm to women and children, radically alter our legal landscape, and discriminate against religious communities, Wagner said. This legislation would deny female athletes fair competition in sports, ignore women's unique health needs, and force vulnerable girls to share intimate spaces with men who identify as female. The Equality Act also punishes and marginalizes people who hold decent and honorable beliefs about marriage or dare to believe the scientific evidence regarding the physical differences between men and women. Also, evangelist Franklin Graham of Samaritan's Purse spoke out against the Equality Act bill. He said this bill will diminish religious freedom. In a Facebook post, Graham explained that the measure, despite the positive sounding name, is deceiving and has nothing to do with equality. It's just a smokescreen to force Americans to accept the LGBTQ agenda, and it creates a lot of inequality for Christians and all people of faith, he warned. He also continued to say it punishes individuals and organizations that disagree based on their moral convictions. If passed into law, the Equality Act could prohibit religious organizations, that is Jewish, Protestants, Catholic, Muslim, all, and churches from hiring only like-minded people who believe what they believe, he continued. Graham added that the legislation would destroy women's and girls' sports in this country in favor of biological males self-identified as female to compete for titles, scholarships, and recognition at all age levels. Women's privacy in public places such as locker rooms, dressing rooms, homeless shelters, restrooms, and more would also be affected, he said. God made us male and female, and that's it, Graham asserted. With some 6,000 years of human history, it has only been in the last few years that people have come up with all sorts of additional designations for gender identity. In his closing remarks, Graham argued Americans to contact their local elected officials as well as the White House to express their concerns about the Equality Act. This is a very dangerous bill, and I strongly encourage you to write your representatives in Congress and the Senate, your governor, even your state legislators, and express your concerns. ask senators to vote no on the Equality Act and pray for God to move in the hearts of these legislators and open their eyes to see the dangers looming before us, he concluded.
Every single person is made in the image of God. And because of that, every single person has inestimable dignity and value. We believe, as our founding document said, that God is the one that endows us with the inalienable rights that we have. They ought to be protected and respected, but unfortunately, the Democrats' misguided effort here tramples all over many of those fundamental rights that God gives us, the right to life, the right to religious freedom. While it's true that H.R. 5 does not include the words abortion, our colleagues keep reminding us of that, it does reference pregnancy and, quote, related medical conditions as areas of protection against discrimination. Everybody knows that that historically leads to the inclusion of abortion. We're opening a door here for the rampant taxpayer funding of abortions on demand.
Florida. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. It's not clothing or personal style that offends God, but rather the use of one's appearance to act out or take on a sexual identity different from the one biologically assigned by God at birth. In his wisdom, God intentionally made each individual uniquely either male or female. When men or women claim to be able to choose their own sexual identity, they are making a statement that God did not know what he was doing when he created them.